Yeah,
I need
how much
that.
That shit cost, bro?
I ain't gonna lie, at the time, man, it cost like two something bands.
Damn.
Man.
Oh wow,
fast, bro. Now it's like what, probably 1600.
Yeah,
still up there though, right? Still a bag
for sure.
But yeah, I was like, man, damn, I gotta get this. You feel me? He was like, you know what you gotta do. You feel me? My dad, he believed in my dream, bro. So I got it and I went to work.
Get to the money and slide. Get to the money and slide. Free all the bros inside. Free all the bros inside. Play with the bros, you die. Huh? Yeah. Get to the money and slide, huh? Free all the bros inside, huh? Play with the bros, you die, huh? Yeah.
Hey man, say man, it's the Got 15 podcast coming back, man. Volume 2, man. Part who knows, and I got a special guest to my left, man. Go ahead and shout yourself out, my boy.
Y'all already know, man. It's your boy Caleb J-O-E Joe.
Yes, sir, man. Yeah. Yes, sir. Hey, look, man. Make sure y'all go subscribe to my boy channel, man. Follow him. Instagram, all his socials, bro. He been blowing up, bro.
Okay.
Blowing up. And we love to see the black excellence. You know what I'm saying? Like, we trying to make sure that we collab with all the cool folks that's blowing up right now. You know what I'm saying? We trying to make sure we all go up together, bro.
So, bro, like, I was going through your YouTube, and you've been doing YouTube about 3 years now, bro. Yeah.
3 years, 7 months.
So, oh, you know the date. Okay, so what made you start doing YouTube, bro?
Man, I ain't going to lie. So, you know, I'm in high school playing basketball. Me and my homeboys, we at Zaxby's, you know, after practice. I'm talking about, I already got a homeboy that do YouTube, you feel me? Like, he got like a million plus right now. He going crazy. Like, he do like gaming and stuff, you feel
Ooh.
Me?
Yeah.
His name, Blake. His own channel called Yumi.
Okay.
He was doing YouTube, but like, I ain't, you feel me? Like, all I know, he was making good money from it and stuff.
Yeah.
But like, we was all in Zaxby's one night, man. We was like, man, let's go to Walmart. You feel me? So like my first video, it's a Walmart video, like Walmart shenanigans, something like that.
Right.
So like I'm talking about, we going to Walmart. We just started doing crazy stuff. You feel me? Like
like what, bro?
Man, we was jumping in the little, you know, it's like a pillow thing, like without the pillows. We was jumping in that. We were throwing stuff. Like we was just doing crazy stuff.
Yeah,
like,
having fun and shit.
Not
bro.
Too crazy. Like not what I would do now. Like I'd go real crazy if I did one of those videos. Now you feel me? But like we was like doing just like funny stuff, little stuff. So I did that. You feel me? I went home, I edited the video. I'm talking about, I ain't know how to work iMovie. And then it's like my first time ever like doing something like that. So like, I get home, I edit it. I come to school the next day. I'm like, y'all, look at this. They're like, man, that jump funny. Yeah. You feel me? So I posted it. I mean, it's lame now, but it was funny back then. You feel me? But I posted it. Everybody was like, man, keep doing this. But like, people don't know, like, Caleb Joe Show, that really come from Snapchat, like with me. Cause like, bro, I was young. I was in middle school, bro. I used to do like a Caleb Joe Show on the, I used to get on there, just talk about stuff, do funny like skits. I used to have like a wig on, like my mama wig or my sister. Like I took one of their wigs, you feel me? I just like used to do funny stuff, you feel me? And like, it just really started from there. So I was like, I'm gonna name my YouTube channel that. So I named it that, and I just kept on going.
Sure, bro.
So you was never worried about nobody judging you or nothing? You never care about that, bro?
Never, bro. Like, bro, when I first started YouTube, if you look at my videos, my old vids, you would see, like, I was really just posting anything. Like, like, I mean, now I be trying to post banger content, you feel
me? Of course.
Me, in a little bit, like, after this, you feel me, I'm just not going up for real, for real.
Like, we know, because, like, now you kind of know the sauce. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, okay, let me make sure that I'm putting out good quality content consistently. Cause, I mean, because same thing with us in the beginning, like, bro, it's so crazy because like folks were like supporting us back then, and then we look at we like, bro, that shit was ass. Like, why the fuck would y'all like it? Like that shit was not good.
Not trying to watch that shit.
But like, I can't watch that shit now. But it's like we know now that all right, bro. Like once we're making a video, we gotta make sure that we're trying to be smart about it. Like actually put effort into doing that shit, bro.
Facts, man. Back then,
and that shit show off in your work though, bro.
Yeah, back then, bro, I just record something. Edit a little bit, drop it. Like, I was on iMovie, you feel me? Like, that's what a lot of people don't know, man. Like, when I first started out, I was on my phone. Recording. On this phone right here, actually, man. It's, bro, I didn't have this phone that long since 2018, man. Crack phone, everything. But, like, I recorded, I edited, all that. Like, but now, you feel me? I got, like, Premiere Pro and all that.
Yeah,
stuff.
For sure.
Like,
yes, sir.
You got to start from the bottom first, though, for real.
Yeah, we definitely used to
record. Bro, we know that shit, nigga. Yeah, iPhones and ring lights.
So, what type of camera you got now?
So now, you feel me? Well, so after the phone, my dad, he gave me, well, he bought me a M100, Canon M100 for my birthday. But you feel me? Like, it was time to upgrade, you feel me? Because I was getting bigger. So I was like, dad, I got to get me a better camera. So you feel me? Me and my dad and my mom and all that's like, we like a big family or whatever. But like, they came through. They believed in my dream, you feel me? So shout out to my mom and dad.
That shit is necessary, bro. Like, because like, my mom is the same way. Like, she always going to fuck with whatever. Like, I try and do, and that shit is, you know what I'm saying? That shit's legit.
As long as they see you passionate about it, they don't really care.
Yeah, facts.
So, like, man, we went to Best Buy. I already was like searching cameras out, you feel me? Cause like I was just passionate about it. So I was like a Sony A7 III. Like I know it costs a lot there, but yeah, I need
that. How much that shit cost, bro?
I ain't gonna lie, at the time, man, it cost like two something bands.
Damn.
Oh wow, facts, bro. Now it's like what, probably 1600.
Yeah,
still up there though, right? Still a bag
for sure.
But yeah, I was like, man, dad, I gotta get this. You feel me? He was like, you know what you gotta do. You feel me? My dad, he believed in my dream, bro. So I got it and I went to work. You feel me? Like, and once I grind and stuff, like I already know who to get back to. You feel me?
Yeah.
My family first.
For sure.
They come first. You feel me? God, thank God too, man. Shout out to God, no cap, because he helped me a lot too.
Bro, I was watching a lot of your videos, and you mentioned God in a lot of your videos.
Right at the beginning.
You think it's important to have a relationship with God to be successful, bro?
No cap.
Yeah.
Very much so. And the reason I say that is because, like, bro, you ain't got God, man, you can't really do nothing. You feel me? Like, I could be doing stuff, but it won't be right. You feel me? Like, yeah. I just be doing stuff off of, like, my own will. You feel me?
Yeah.
But I don't want to do it like that. I want to do it, like, having God in me. You feel me? Because if God in me and with me, then he going to lead me and guide me to the right path. You feel me? I won't get the big head. I stay humble. You feel me? Because that's one big thing that I'm trying to do, bro. And, like, also with the money coming in, you feel me? Like, because it's going to start coming in for sure.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
feel me? Like, I'm just, you know, put my base on God, you feel me? My trust in God, like that he tell me and lead me and guide me to do the right thing with it. Cause I don't wanna, you feel me, just get my money and just blow it, you feel me? Cause yeah, I see a lot of people doing that.
And that's why I fuck with social media so heavy, mm-hmm. bro. And like, I think that's why I encourage any of my niggas who trying to get into that shit, bro. Do that shit. Cause it's like, it's a way to get us young niggas, bro, some early ass money.
That's facts, bro.
And if we get that shit now and be smart with it, bro, it's like, if we getting it at 19, 20, 21, bro, some niggas ain't getting this amount of money till they 50, bro, yes, 45. To them niggas, you know what I'm saying, pulling in two jobs, working overtime and shit, and they still not making.
Can really be said at 35.
You see what I'm saying? Like, bro, and like, that's why I think it's really important that you said that, bro, because we trying to make sure that we also, like, keep the brand of just making sure that everybody that we connect with is going up, you know what I mean? Like, going up the right way to where they're going to keep their shit, bro.
Yeah, I think the best part about YouTube is, like, you know, this is a job to us, basically, but it's fun, bro. It's like, I don't, when I come down here record, I'm not like, bro, I don't feel like doing it today. I always want to do it. It's fun. Meeting new people, talking to new people, bro. Like, it's a job, but it's a fun job to do, and I like doing it. Yeah. You know, people got 9 to 5.
It has its days, though, bro. I ain't gonna hold you.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That editing shit, it has its days.
Wake up, be like, bro, I don't feel like editing this whole video.
Stuff
bro.
Deleting on accident, bro. Stuff not loading right.
Big facts, man. Oh my God. I had a whole vid that I did, man. It got deleted.
Oh, yeah, we already know that shit, bro. Many a podcast is gonna vanish, nigga. Audio is gone or some shit.
Recently, like, my hard drive, I had a 5 terabyte hard drive, like, crashed on me. I'm talking about all
5 terabytes?
Yeah, all the footage gone. You feel me? This guy's playing, though. I ain't even tripping. You feel me?
Exactly.
And like, right after that, now this happening. You feel me? So, I ain't tripping. Yeah, something got to happen, you feel me? Go wrong, go left, and then some good going to happen eventually. Like, I ain't tripping, man.
And everything.
Stay prayed up.
I fought that mindset, bro.
Yeah, everything definitely happened for a reason. That's just anything in life, though. It's not always good all the time, bro.
Yeah.
And that's the point where when stuff go left, you got to keep going regardless, bro. Because you can't get up. You can't give up. You really can't do that.
So, bro, you've been doing YouTube for, like, over 3.5 years, but, like, you just recently started. So, like, what you been doing differently that you feel like, all right, yeah, this is the reason why it's just starting to go stupid? Or you feel like it's just a consistent thing?
Honestly, man, it's really just consistency, bro. For sure. I mean, like, I ain't gonna lie, like, when I first started out, I feel like I was going way more harder than I am now. Like, I ain't gonna care, because I was posting videos, like, literally, like, every day, like, every other day. Like, now I post probably once a week, you know, every Sunday. Like, that's what I've been posting ever since school started, too. Mm-hmm. But, like, yeah, I was going way more harder and stuff, like, back then. And then even the video that blew up, like, it took 10 months for that video to blow. You feel me? So, I mean.
So what, it was 10 months after you had posted it that started to go up?
Facts.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Like, that's really how my first video ever on YouTube, like, blew up. And that was my pillow fight video.
Yeah, I seen
that used to be my highest view video before all these other ones.
Now you got the ding dong ditch ones are your best ones right now.
Yeah. Okay. I was talking to somebody, and they told me, like, YouTube is good to look at YouTube as, like, online real estate, bro. How you can post a video and later YouTube will still put it on people's pages and, it'll blow up way later.
Yeah.
You know, TikTok, if you post it, if it don't blow up right then, it's not going to blow up.
Shit, that's not true though, because the vaccine video, bro. I mean, it wasn't 10 months, but as far as TikTok time it goes, bro, 2 weeks is like, nigga, that shit dead and gone. Like, it blew up way more than it was supposed to. Two, 3 weeks later than it was posted though.
That's true. But YouTube, bro, like, it's funny. I'm on YouTube now, but not too long ago, I didn't know YouTube was an app, bro.
Yeah, dead ass. That's how it was when I first started that, but then like when I came to YouTube, I ain't gonna lie, I started doing videos more. I just started watching them more.
You know, bro, and that, I don't understand how he does not watch YouTube videos, bro.
I don't be on YouTube like that.
I don't understand. I mean, it ain't nothing wrong with that, cause at the end of the day, man, if you don't watch YouTube for real, you won't never like want to have to copy somebody's stuff. You always be original.
That's true.
That's one good thing about like not watching YouTube. If you don't watch YouTube, you can do your own thing. You feel me? Like if you watch it, you gonna want to more so like do like not exactly what somebody else do, but like similar.
And that's one thing we try to keep, make sure we're original in everything we do, bro. Because we like to just be different, bro. That's how I feel like that's how you blow up as well. Being different, not being like everybody else.
Being authentic, bro. That's the main thing. Like as long as you like, I feel like, and people really value that shit, especially on social media. Like,
yeah, you can tell.
Just you being authentic, your authentic self, and it's like if that shit is entertaining on top of that, bro, it's like a combo effect that shit really blow up. Because you could be entertaining on that fake shit, and niggas will watch it.
Yeah.
But they'll still not have no respect for you because they know it's on that fake lame shit, bro.
Yeah, that's true.
Like a nigga like Boom Gang, like, bro, he just go around robbing.
Yeah, it's like, oh, yeah, it's funny. I'm going to watch it, but it's like.
You famous now, but it's like, for what?
Yeah.
So did you have anybody, like, inspire you to do YouTube? Like, you have any YouTubers that you just like and they make you keep going or anything like that?
Honestly, like, I'm being 100% honest. I really don't. Like, I mean, I watch a lot of YouTubers. Y'all will understand, like, bro, I watch white YouTubers, black YouTubers, like, any color, like, it don't matter, like, any type of genre, you feel me? Like, I'm an outdoor type of guy. Like, I'm a country type of guy at heart, you feel me? I'm from the country for real. Yeah. So, like, bruh, like, I literally be watching, like, it's a fishing group. They call it, like, Guggen Squad. I don't know if y'all know about them, but, like, I watch anything, really. So, like, I ain't got no favorite, you feel me, favorite person. I just watch all the time. It's just, like, everybody I watch, I, like, take it, and I just put it in, like, to one. You feel me? And I just create around that. Yeah, like if I have my influence on anybody,
yeah. Yeah, and you can always, you know, watch different videos, take a piece from somebody, take a piece from, and when you put it together, make it your own, bro. That's really how you make it.
It's kind of interesting being on your page because, like, you go from a Ding Dong Ditch video where you being all a menace, and then there's a video you training with your dog. It's like, bro, it's two different sizes.
Nobody ain't never got on YouTube training with their dog.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Then he go from that all the way to him and his girl.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Some couple shit. But I fuck with that shit. Okay, so, like, if you clearly can move around this shit. I see you got your YouTube going. You got the Instagram. Like, what other platforms you plan on going to?
I mean, I'm on TikTok, but not really, though.
Okay.
I had one vid go up on there. That was, like, the little Levitain prank. I did on my mom and my brother. Mm-hmm. Like, that one hit, like, 900K or something like that. Right. Like, that really turned my TikTok up. It got, like, 9,000 followers. But then, like, I really ain't post on it for real because, like, I don't know. I just ain't got
Look, let me tell you something, bro. Real shit, bro. Real shit.
TikTok.
Gotta get your TikTok going, bro. I'm telling you because, like,
especially with your content, like, bro, that shit goes stupid on TikTok, bro.
I'm telling you, bro, like, if the shit blow on YouTube, it's gonna blow 10 times harder on TikTok. I swear to God, bro.
Yeah, send your video out like crazy, bro.
Yeah, like, TikTok, I'm telling you, bro. TikTok, bro, you like, cause and then like you'll really be like, you'll see a direct impact on your views, bro.
Yeah.
Like your video get a million, and then if you sitting there like focusing, hey, go sub to my YouTube channel, go watch the full video on the YouTube, they gonna click that shit, and it's gonna turn that shit up, bro.
Okay.
And bro, like, TikTok really has been taking care of us.
That
like,
shit ain't going live.
Yeah.
They're live.
Like, I would say,
we can show you some sauce on TikTok, bro. For sure, bro.
How many? Okay, so I'll just say we at 6,000 subscribers right now. I think last time I checked was like 5.94.
Nah, some shit, yeah.
So I'll just say we at 6,000 subscribers. How many of our subscribers do you think came from TikTok, bro?
I would have to say at least 4.
Minimum, I was going to say at least 5, bro.
And then I was going to say, like, out of our views, I would say it's probably like 65% is from TikTok for sure.
People will have a video blow up on TikTok and then we got the link in the bio.
Instantly see
and
it
go straight to the YouTube, bro.
That's how the Dean Don Ditch the first. Well, no, so me and my boy Wine there on your next level, Noah, he the one that be in the Dean Don Ditch with me. His vid, I don't know, they took it from his vid, they put it on TikTok, but that was the second one though. The first time the video had blew up on his channel, and he got some clout off that for sure. And then the second one, that's when like it had went on
TikTok.
Yeah, some random dude like, bro, he just posted
and
or whatever.
They'll just repost that shit, and that shit'll blow up again.
I'm talking about like 40 million right now, like that's,
bro.
That's crazy. Like,
that's ridiculous.
And that's what I'm saying. It's like, it's, I don't know, I ain't saying it's easier on TikTok, but it's easier. You know what I mean? It's like you can, and then like you can take one video that you spend, you know what I'm saying, like the same amount of time. All right, then I just gotta chop it down to five little TikToks, and it's like, all right, you're gonna get that organic shit from YouTube. Yeah. Then you're finna get five more chances to get views, you know what I'm saying, on the YouTube type shit, bro. And that shit, butter, bro. And with that being said, man, it's been the Got 15 podcast, and we out, man. Peace.
Get to the money and slide, get to the money and slide. Free all the bros inside, free all the bros inside. Play with the bros, you die, huh, yeah. Get to the money and slide, huh. Free all the bros inside, huh. Play with the bros, you die, huh.